Hey, it's Jang here from LegoJang.com with Lego City Coast Guard Patrol. This is set number 60014, released in spring to summer of 2013. It comes with supposedly 449 pieces. I got it from Toys R Us, and the price you'll see it sold for is between $75 and $85 throughout the year from different sources. So we've actually had a set like this previously, back in 2008, the last time that we had the Coast Guard sub theme of City released. The last time we had a set like this, it was set number 7739. It was called Coast Guard Patrol Boat and Tower. So they've basically taken the theme of that one and adjusted it a little bit and kind of moved the parts around, and I believe they ended up giving us a lot more with this one. If you want to check out that other one, once again, it's set number 7739. I would recommend checking it out on a brick set or a Lego Wikia, wherever your favorite place is. It's an interesting comparison between the two. So on this one, let's go ahead and take a look at the components that we get with it. There are quite a number of components aside from the main ship, which I'll get to last. First off, minifigures. Okay, we have two passengers. Here is the male passenger, and he is on a boat, just a regular citizen passenger boat. He has nothing to do with the Coast Guard boat. He's one of the people who's being rescued, and here you can see what he looks like with the nice, well-detailed personal flotation device removed from him. I do like that PFD. This is the female passenger, who is also out on the same boat, the little green boat that we'll look at later on. And she also is in need of rescue. And I find it very interesting, her priorities, because their boat is crashing. It's going to sink into these really rough, rocky waters with sharks. And she's holding on to her popsicle stick because that's very important that she saves that from the sharks. You know, she can get eaten, the guy she's with can get eaten, but her popsicle stick will be the last thing to get eaten because she's really gonna protect it. Okay, moving on. We have here the captain. This is the captain of the Coast Guard cutter, or the Coast Guard patrol boat. He's your main guy. He's in charge of the entire show. And then moving on, we get a crew member, and there are two crew members, and they call one of them officially crew member and one rescuer, but they're basically the same thing. They have the same torso piece, the same personal flotation device, the same cap, just a different head piece. As you can see here, one of them has the facial hair on him. But there's something that I want to call out here in particular that is new and very interesting to me, is this headset. That's new. And it's actually attached, it's separate, but it's attached removably to the top using a mini-sized peg. So, you know, the half-sized peg that's used for attaching things to headgear and hair pieces. That's what they did here. And that fits on really well onto this cap. So the cap really works either way, whether you have it on there or not, but it works great. And I think it's the best looking set of ear headphones that they've come up with yet, period, in any form to date. I'm really, really happy with those. They're not too bulky. And then finally, we have the Coast Guard helicopter pilot. And he's a pretty serious helicopter jockey, really takes his job seriously. You know, obviously a very important job, also a very difficult job. So that kind of explains what's going on with his face. It does require a lot of skill, and you know that he has quite a lot of piloting skill to rescue people out of the water in rough waters, because he has to really line things up carefully. And that takes care of the minifigures, except if you want to call this a minifigure, a German Shepherd dog. Not the first time that we've gotten this one with the print on it, but it's one with the print on it, so that's cool. And he went with the two passengers of the boat that are being rescued. So they had their dog out with them on the boat. Okay, let's move all these out of the way for now, including the dog. He wants to stay behind, but since a dog is an animal, what else is an animal? This is an animal, a shark with the hinged head, dark bluish gray color. You get three of them. That is a surprise. It's really unnecessary to put in that many, but it kind of just drives home the fact that these are very, very dangerous waters. They could have just included one in this set, I think, and it would have been enough, especially with that over there, which we'll see in a minute. But they gave us three, so I'm not complaining. Moving along, I will show this in context a little bit later, but this is a remotely operated submersible, and that's actually going to get launched off the back of the stern of the main Coast Guard ship. And this has a lot of articulation to it. You can rotate these around so it's able to pilot itself directly down. It's able to go directly up. And they actually act as thrusters, so it can, you know, it can kind of roll and bank and pitch as it's swimming along. So that's pretty cool. And this is just for basically getting to things that are underwater. You can see they use these pieces that are designed for holding onto flat plates, and they use them as little pinchers or little robotic hands at the ends of these arms. Those can turn up and down, and you've got some nice articulation here. It's able to reach a lot of places, so that's pretty cool. And obviously there would be a camera in there. You've got lights right there. Another add-on thing they included with the set is this pretty impressive helicopter. So let me move this off to the side for a second. Let's just look at the helicopter. I believe this is a new build for a helicopter. It has a fair number of parts in it, actually, and they've got these nice floats that represent, you know, the regular helicopter floats, so it can actually land on water. It's not something that they really do very frequently, and they try to avoid that, but it is something that it can do. Of course, you've got the spinning blades, and these are locked in place really nicely. I like the fact that they used these hinge pieces with the hinge towards the inside. It gives a little bit of support, so the blades feel more sturdy. You've got a couple of stickers used on there, here on the tail. Spinning tail rotor, nice. It's got lights, marker lights. This does open up. You've got the moving two different levers. Doesn't look very good right there. I don't like the appearance of this when it's open sideways like that. These are actually these tall sloped pieces. But still, for just a small little add-on helicopter, it's a lot of parts used here, and it has extra functionality. You already saw this. There's a winch back here, and this can actually lower that down, a little grappling hook kind of thing. And you can attach a minifigure. Oh yeah, just put a hook in his mouth. That's not too cool. Okay, there we go. So you can just let him be lowered down. Your pilot would be inside of here, and he would be lowered down, pick up one of the passengers, you know, kind of hook onto him, lift him up and take him to the boat, drop him off, and lather, rinse, repeat. So that's how that would work out. So that's nice that not only do you get a large number of parts here, you have a pretty good looking thing, but you also have the ability to do something with it. So far, so very good on value for this set. Moving on, I'll get to that next. This is the boat that's being thrashed against the shore that has lost power, and it's punctured, and it's going to be sinking pretty soon. They call it a dinghy, but it's a pretty powerful boat with a hard bottom to it, the whole base. Yeah, it's kind of basic, but it does its job. It plays the part. Looks like just a leisure passenger boat that would be owned by these folks, and you know, they were just taking it out for a nice little spin on the water to enjoy themselves. This is a piece that I personally have not seen before. That's an interesting piece, 2x2, with just a very slight angle to the side and a single stud on top. I have not done the research yet to see if that is a new part for summer 2013 altogether, but like I said, I haven't ever seen it before, so maybe, maybe not. That's a sticker that's added on there, so that's just an exclusive sticker piece. This is a little tanning deck, so a figure could sit down here and just kind of lay out and get some sun with the head on this side. Let me go ahead and do that. safety first. Make sure you use your suntan lotion, right? Sunscreen, very important. And then on the back of this, we've got a really nice outboard engine. Really nice. Good size. It's got that grill texture from a classic car and a large propeller that spins. And this can be brought up if you have a trailer that you make for it, or if you see this being stored on the shore or at somebody's large house, you can pull that up so it's not scraping the propeller. You can also adjust the trim. Maybe if you're planing a little bit too high, adjust the trim down, and this also will turn back and forth. So again, nice little add-on thing, more than it needs to be. I can't complain. Next, lighthouse. So this is the biggest thing that has changed from the last Coast Guard large boat set, which put a lot of parts into a lighthouse. They had a pretty major lighthouse before. This is pretty basic. Really isn't serving much function here other than to give some shore sort of detail to let you know that you're by the shore. They do give you a little crab that's a nice little add-on. This is the more modern one piece. There's actually two here of the large rock pieces with the slopes on the side. The main thing that this is doing is helping to drive home the danger of the situation that the folks on this boat are in. Not only are they in shark infested waters, but they've got this boat that's coming ashore and it's kind of being thrashed by the waves into the edge here, and that's making it break apart even more. It's losing more and more buoyancy, and it's going to sink much sooner. And they can't just jump off easily onto the rocks because they're really jagged. So that's really what this whole piece right here is doing. It's just helping to set the scene, in my opinion. It's just contributing to the overall scenario that we're in. It doesn't really do so much as something that you can play with. All right, now let's talk about the ship itself. Nice size to it. So I'll bring in the minifigure again just to give you the, I should bring in the captain. He's the one who deserves to be on deck, if anybody does. There you can see the scale of that. So this is pretty decent size and a lot of detail, a lot of different colors on it. In my opinion, definitely the best Coast Guard boat that LEGO has released, period, ever. One of the better looking boats for the theme, regardless of theme. I think better fitting that I have ever seen. I love the detail. They do use some stickers, not more than a minimum amount, but it's not an annoying amount to me. I think it's right on the edge. I don't like a lot of stickers to be used, but these do their job very well. They give proper detail. They really let you know what you're looking at, and just helps out a lot. There's space underneath of here. You can kind of store gear under there. These are little rotating water cannons. Unfortunately, these Exo-Force arms don't like to turn very much. You kind of have to hold them hard to turn them side to side, but then you can go up and down with these for fighting fires. If you come up against any fire on the water, that's very important for a rescue boat to have. And LEGO actually suggests that you use these to scare away the sharks. Nice, very large superstructure here. A lot of detail on there. You can see it's like a radar bar that turns around. There's another one over here. Antennae, the light posts, these big exhaust stacks. You got a light back here. Another small antenna. This, I'll show you how this works in a minute. You've got a couple more additional just spare flotation devices to throw to folks who you're trying to rescue. This whole thing can come off easily, which that doesn't really do much except giving you the ability to see down there if you're going to store anything down there. But then that rotates open, and then you can see inside. So there's where your captain sits right there. See if I can zoom in on this just a little bit, give you a little more. Yeah, that's where your captain would sit, and he has access to throttle controls. You can see radar readouts, probably some weather map. He's got his coffee mug, Lego in there, coffee mugs all the time. He's got the main wheel. And then back over here, this is for another crew member to sit there. He actually operates the lift on the back of this ship. I'll show you what that's all about in a second. He also has a little control panel. He's probably the remote operator also for the remote operated submarine. So that's an interesting thing. We've got these bumpers all the way around. We've got four bumpers for when you come up to shore, or if you are coming up alongside another boat. So that's interesting. Not really necessary, but looks nice. Nice bit of detail. Folks who are around boats a lot will recognize those and understand them. So here's the lift. What's the lift all about? Well, it's all about this. It's all about your little remote operated vehicle. And it's going to attach like so, and that's actually stored right there. Look at that. Fits perfectly, nice and securely. It's not going anywhere. When it's time to launch it, so we will bring you over here. When it's time to launch this, and it just lets go. Just like, come on, let go. There we go. It's not that bad. Let's go. And you bring it back in board, and this thing takes off. When it's time to pick it up, you just bring this down, get it in place, and just very nicely just lift this up. Make sure that the arms are folded in, and there you go. It just all falls into place. It's perfect. It's absolutely perfect. I love it. Awesome. Up front, you've got space here too, and you notice that's an H. You know what H means. It means helipad. That is where the helicopter lands. And it's supposed to get, yeah, there it goes. Look at that. The way that these are situated, these bracket pieces, fits right into the slot, in there. And it holds the helicopter in place. So that the helicopter, if I did it right, there we go. It's not gonna move side to side. It's not held in like it's attached. But it just slots it in, keeps it from really going anywhere if you're just playing with it pretty normally. And also very helpful if you have this thing on the water and it's kind of, you know, shaking back and forth. And I say that not from imaginative play or an imaginative play perspective, but actually from real play, because this is a unitary hull boat, and that means that it can actually go on water. You can actually float this boat, which is a great thing for younger kids who want to play with this. Actually put it on the water and see it, you know, play with it in the bathtub, see it floating around. The dinghy also floats. Everything, you know, actually works on water, which is just a great thing that they do nowadays, consistently always making sure that these boats that they make are able to float. So that takes care of this set. I like this set oh so very much. I think it's a big improvement over the previous one that they used to have, or that they brought out in 2008. I think that this is a much better use of parts. This has a similar number of parts to the old one, but I think you get a lot more play value out of this version than you did of the old one. And I like the look of it. I like the build. It's simple enough, but complex enough. It's not boring. Really happy about this one. 80 bucks, a little bit on the expensive side for sure, but you know, nowadays I don't talk so much about cost of Lego stuff unless I see something that's outrageously expensive or incredibly cheap. I think that this one is kind of in the normal expensive range for the number of parts and the amount of playability that you get for a Lego set. So that's it. Thanks for sticking in there with me, and I hope that you will stick around even more to watch even more reviews from System City, Hero Factory, Chima, you name it. I love a lot of Lego stuff, so I'll be bringing you a lot more. Talk to you again soon.